The companies, they don't like people to see what they do. So transparency is really a very good tool. What we say very often is that the companies, they are like Dracula. They don't like sun. And so we put them in the sun, and for them it's terrible.
José Bové is no ordinary Frenchman. At times he has come across as larger than life, stirring up a crowd in Seattle, interfering with construction of a McDonald's deep in France, trampling biotech corn, or being cuffed off to jail. He's a farmer, but 2 years ago he went from herding sheep in the southwest of France into full-time politics. The former farm union leader from Larzac is now a member of the European Parliament.
What we see clearly is how the transnational companies want to take the power at the European level, but also in the national countries. It's very clear that they try to corrupt all the levels. Of course, they try to work directly inside of the European Commission, the Parliament, but also in all the committees or the agencies of Europe. And of course, now they're focusing more at the European level, because if we are able to have common laws at the European level, it's easier after to go inside of the countries. But for doing that, they need also the help of some governments who can be their support inside, for example, of the Council.
For me, it's essential to go into battle locally, but also to mobilize at a European level and internationally.
Tobacco industry is quite interesting because it's one of the biggest lobby in the world. Do not go in front of the court. In 2004, they accepted to give hundreds of million euros to the anti-fraud organism to fight against the fraud in tobacco. So they pay directly. This is a completely incredible situation.
Mais on voit que les lobbies sont prêts à tout et actuellement, elles sont à nouveau à l'œuvre dans le cadre de la préparation de l'accord de libre-échange entre les États-Unis et l'Union européenne.
I think that what's happening with TTIP is one of the craziest things. So this is, I think, a very big challenge for the people to struggle in front. And we can win this fight. Because we have to know that in the United States, a lot of people don't want it. Because it's going to change at the local, for the local authorities. The big companies coming from Europe, they want to open the market in the little communities, and the people don't want. They want to have their own activity with their own companies at the local place. But in Europe, we have to make this fight, because there's one reason which is very important, is that the companies want to impose inside of TTIP a new rule saying that the companies can attack the states if the law of the state go against their own interest. And they are going to have the control of all the life of the people. And this is the dream of the companies, to take the place of democracy.
He was elected under the flag of the Greens in 2009 and then slipped naturally into the vice president's seat in the Agriculture Committee, a strategic position to defend Europe's farmers.
In general, the populist parties, they say we are against corruption because in general they have been never in power. So it's very easy. They have their hands white. And they say we are the only one who can fight against corruption. But we have to say clearly, when they are in responsibility, or for example when they are at the European Parliament, they don't vote what they say in their own countries. The representative of Jobbik was not there to vote the reform of CAP policy and to make the blockage for the bigger farms. Mrs. Morvai was not there in the parliament. And we lost this vote only for two people.
Et ce dont on peut se rendre compte, c'est que de plus en plus, les firmes, les grandes transnationales, essayent de prendre le pouvoir sur la démocratie.
We need to have, for example, at the European Commission, to have more decisions, to have no revolving doors. That means if you have been working at a high level in the European Commission, not able to work before 3 or 5 years in the private companies before, after I've been working in the European Commission. Having a stronger register of the lobbies inside of the parliament, but globally in front of the European institution. Have a control, a democratic control on the OLAF. We need a very transparency to be sure things like this can happen. To be sure also in all the agencies that the people who are in responsibility in the agencies have been never working for companies before. This is what we found when we were making our fight against GMOs. We found that the president of the alimentation agency was directly member of one of the biggest lobby in the world for agri-industrial food. And this was Mrs. Banati coming from Hungary. And so we were able to kick her out from the agency. And now she works again directly for the office of this big lobby, which is called ILSI. We need more power for the European Parliament, for the Parliament to be able to propose the laws, the directives directly, not only to have to vote the directives which are proposed by the European Commission. We have to increase democracy also for the nomination and the pluralism of the commissioners. Europe is still something we are building, and it's not finished. In this moment, the European Parliament is the most democratic parliament we have. It's more democratic than most of the national parliaments we have. So we have to reinforce and also to fight for democracy in the countries.